Hey, Harvest family, it's Wednesday, and I'm glad to be with you. And just wanted to say, in the wake of what happened this weekend, how blessed and thankful I am, and I'm sure you are. God did amazing things in our service through our Good Friday and our Easter celebrations. I'm just so proud of our staff and the hard work that they put in, and then I'm so thankful to God for the fruitfulness. We had people worshiping from all around the country, all around the world. We had 176 people say yes to Christ. And so I'm so encouraged and thankful for that. And as high as that was, I just want to be honest with you, kind of today I'm struggling, and maybe some of you might be too. It's kind of interesting, after big spiritual highs, sometimes there can be lows. I think of Elijah at Mount Carmel when God destroyed the prophets of Baal, and immediately Elijah goes to a really difficult season in his life. I kind of feel like that today. I think I'm a little discouraged. I'm tired from a long season of ministry. I think that I had some hard discussions and even have some hard decisions to make for the church and things with our team as we discuss things that are going on. And I'm a little overwhelmed by some of those things. Just feeling a little bit down, and I guess it's not, maybe it's the work of the enemy in the midst of such a great spiritual victories from the weekend, that I'm a little bit struggling today. Kind of feel like a little bit has to do with the coronavirus thing too, and the lockdown and the quarantine. I'm tired of it. I love people, and I miss my church family. I miss my extended family. Hard to not be with them on Easter. And even as great as things were, it's just, I think, hard to deal with the reality. We've been doing it for, 3 weeks or so? And we're kind of like halfway through. Well, I think about it like, you know, Wednesday is hump day. Well, I think this week is hump week for us as it relates to the lockdown. We're right in the middle, pretty much, I think, and maybe it might be extended. And so I'm feeling maybe a little bit sorry for myself. So what do you do in these situations? You go to the Lord and you go to his word. And so I'm just kind of sharing you my journey, how I'm feeling today. And I got some scriptures that God is using to help me that I've found over my lifetime. When I do get discouraged, sometimes I'm usually pretty joyful. It's the first thing I pray for in my journal time, is that God would continue to give me the joy of the Lord. And I'm usually pretty joyful, but just today I'm feeling a little bit discouraged. But God has given me some verses, and I want to share them with you. The first one is Matthew 8:11, verses 28, 29, and 30. Matthew 11:28 says, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Let me just walk through this a little bit. The first thing he says is, come to me. This is a command. Jesus Christ invites us and welcomes us and wants us to come to him when we're burdened, when we're heavy laden, when we're weary. I love that my God can understand that we're not always going to be, you know, joyful in heart, that sometimes we're going to be discouraged. And he commands us, come to me. This is Jesus talking. Jesus wants me in my state. And if you're sharing this with me right now, maybe you're not, maybe you're in a good place, that's awesome, praise God. But if you're kind of discouraged today, Jesus commands you to come to him. And he's got open arms for us. It's not just a command though. It's also a promise. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. There's such definity. He's definitive in that. I will give you rest. It's a promise. And Jesus' promises is true. Just like if you repent from your sins, he's going to save you. If you come to him, he's going to give us rest. So I'm so thankful for that promise. But it's not just a promise. The next thing he gives us in these verses is the prescription. How do we get this rest? Well, he says, come to me, all you heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Then he says, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. He wants us to get into the yoke with him. And Jesus is such a great example. He likely wasn't discouraged like me and you get, because I don't know if discouragement is actually even a sin. I think it's probably a lack of faith, and that is sin. But Jesus wasn't discouraged, but he went through hard things. A lot of hardship in Jesus' life, rejection, and obviously what we just celebrated in his death. the way that he went through those things, we can learn from him. And so in the midst of my troubles today or my discouragement, what do? I look at the person of Jesus and how he handled his things, and I can learn from him. He's such a great example to me. And he's gentle and lowly in spirit. That means when I come, he's not mad that I feel this way. He's not angry with me that I feel this way. He just wants me to come, and he wants to give me that rest. And so if you're struggling like me today, just go to him. Go to him in prayer. Go to him in his word, and he will give you the rest that you're looking for. Really thankful for that. Galatians 6:9, kind of how another thing I'm feeling right now is just a little bit of exhaustion, I think, from just working. It's just different how I'm working now. It feels like I'm always working, even though I'm working from home. It's just kind of everything's meshed together, work time, personal time, and it feels like I'm working a little bit too much. And so I think I'm just tired. And what would God tell me in the midst of it? And he wants me to come to him to find rest. It doesn't mean I just have to quit. I mean, I'm not quitting, and I'm not going to quit working, because God calls us to keep our hand to the plow. But he says in Galatians 6:9 that, and let us not grow weary in doing good, for in due season we will reap if we don't give up. And so knowing that even when it's hard, if I keep loving God and serving God and sacrificing for God, that even when I don't see maybe the fruit directly, I know that God is going to bring about something awesome, because we reap what we sow, it also says in Galatians 6. And he's going to bring a good work through what I'm doing if I don't give up. And so I need to keep persevering. And that's such a great example of the first century Christians, the perseverance that they had even in the midst of their hardship. And my hardship today, just a little bit of discouragement, is nothing like what they went through. And so I just got to keep my hands on the plow. I need to come to Jesus like he asked me to, and I will get the rest. Lastly, one of the things that I do when I'm struggling, or when I'm just interested in finding out more from the Word about a certain subject, I do a word study. And I did a word study on carry, and looking for how God carries us in the midst of it. And it led me to Psalm 28. I'm just going to share a few verses. The carry part's in the last verse, but I'm going to share verses 6-9. Psalm 28:6, blessed be the Lord, for he has heard the voice of my pleas for mercy. I just need to go to him when I'm struggling and ask God for mercy. He hears my prayers. The Lord is my strength and my shield. In him my heart trusts and I am helped. My help comes from God when I'm struggling. It doesn't come from bucking up and like putting on just a happy face, even though that I'm not happy. It comes from going to him, and the strength comes from me allowing him to come to give me what I need. His grace is sufficient for me. His power is made perfect in my weakness. And so I want that power to endure when I'm struggling. Verse 8, the Lord is the strength of his people. Can't be any more clear than that. I don't have strength. The Lord is the strength of his people. He is the saving refuge of his anointed. Oh, save your people and bless your heritage. Be their shepherd and carry them forever. God carries me. When I'm weak, he'll carry me. When I can't walk, he'll carry me. When I can't run, he'll carry me. That is the message that God wants me to hear. And God is encouraging me through these scriptures, even today, in the midst of kind of my little funk. And so hopefully that might be encouraging to you. I don't know, like I said, if anyone's there with me, if you are, maybe that will help you. But if you're not there now, maybe you might get there in the next few weeks or whatever, as this goes on longer and longer. But I'm really thankful because God calls me to come to him. He gives me that strength, and he will give me that rest that I'm looking for. His promises are all true. So hopefully that was an encouragement to you. I'm just going to pray for us, and then we'll be done. So would you join me in prayer? Father God, I thank you that your grace is sufficient for us, Lord. In times of difficulty, trial, even discouragement, Lord, you tell us to come to you. Thank you that you're waiting for me. Thank you that you're waiting for someone who's listening to this message right now, God. And you're just saying, come with open arms. And God, you will give us rest for our souls. Lord, it isn't easy in this season, God. We're kind of in the hump week of maybe what's going on. Maybe it's even going to go longer than that. But God, thank you that you don't leave us alone, that you're carrying us. Lord God, so help that reality, Lord, flood my mind and encourage me and give me strength. And thank you for what you're doing, even in the midst of my discouragement. There's so many amazing things, God, that you're doing. God, what you did this weekend in our Easter services, we praise you for it, Lord. But even tonight, God, people that got saved this weekend are going to come and be a part of a Bible study, Lord, and they're going to take their first steps as new Christians. How encouraging is that? So, God, help me not to just focus on myself, but to focus on you and all that you're doing. I'm even getting uplifted now as I pray it. So thank you for what you're doing in our church. Thank you for what you're doing in my life, Lord. God, thank you that you're there for me always. And I can always come to you, and you're always ready to hear my prayers and to answer them. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, I love you, church family. Miss you a lot. Just remember, you are loved.